हेलो गाइस, गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू। माय नेम इज राकेश शिर्के एंड यू आर वाचिंग माय चैनल। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विथ लेक्चर नंबर 9 फ्रॉम नेचुरल प्रोडक्ट 1। इन दैट वी हैव टू सी 1.3, दैट इज इंसेक्ट फेरोमोन्स। इन दैट व्हाट इज मीन बाय इंसेक्ट फेरोमोन्स, लेट अस सी। Pheromones are chemical agent secreted by insect as sexual attractor. These chemicals are used to attract insects and predict population. So this is insect pheromones part. Okay, in that we have to see first synthesis, that is grandisol from 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. Okay, so in the grandisol synthesis, your main reactant molecule is 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. So first of all, we have to give the number of longest continuous chain. This carbon gives first number, then this one is second, third and fourth. This is your longest continuous chain. And why I am going left to right? Because second position have a substituent and nearest double bond is also there at one position. So the name of this reactant is 2-methyl-buta-1,3-diene, or you may also say 1,3-butadiene. Okay, so this 1,3-butadiene is reacts with but-3-en-2-one. Why I am writing like this? Because when we have to see the structure, the numbering start from this carbon 1, 2, 3, and 4. Why I am writing the numbering right to left? Because nearest functional group is there, so that's why. And third position have a double bond, so I am writing like this. But means what? There are four carbon atom in longest continuous chain, and third position have a en indicate double bond. And why I am remove e part in this name? Because functional group is also present at the second position, and this functional group is ketone, so that's why one we have to write as a suffix. So this two reactant is react in the presence of light, then you will get the two product in the form of cis and trans. How this reaction will happen? The cyclization process take place. Simple. In between 1-2 carbon of the first reactant and 3-4 carbon of the second reactant, the simple cyclization process, this double bond will shifted in between this second and third carbon of two reactant, and this double bond will close the first and fourth carbon atom. Okay, so you will get this cyclic product is in the cis form. Why it is cis? Because CH3 and hydrogen is at the same site, so that's why it is a cis form of the step one product. And why it is trans? Because CH3 and hydrogen is at the opposite side. Okay, and all remaining part is same, only simple cyclization process is done. Then out of that cis and trans, we have to select cis form. Okay, so this cis form is reacts with methyl magnesium fluoride. This is what? Grignard reagent. What is it? Grignard reagent. how to form Grignard reagent, or what is mean by Grignard reagent, when methyl fluoride is reacts with Mg in the presence of dry ether, then you will get this Grignard reagent. This Grignard reagent is added into cis isomers of step 1 product in the presence of ether, and hydrolysis process take place. How to add this CH3Mg into cis form? First of all, we have to add across the double bond MgF part and CH3 from this carbon. Then you will get this carbon atom across double bond, you will get carbon CH3 and OMgF. After that, hydrolysis take place. This hydrolysis means what? Addition of water across this OMg bond, and you will get H from this side, because electronegative group is attracted hydrogen plus part, and OH minus group is attracted toward the magnesium, that is metal part. That means you will get the alcohol form after addition of Grignard reagent into cis form. This one is your product. Then next step is B2H6 means what? This is diborane. In the presence of hydrogen peroxide and NaOH indicate it is basic medium. Why this diborane hydrogen peroxide is used? Because this molecule is convert C double bond C molecule in alcohol form. The role of boron or diborane, and in the presence of hydroxide, you are this ethene molecule or C double bond C molecule is converted into alcoholic group. Let us see in the product. This C double bond C totally reduce, and you will get alcohol. Then your byproduct from is 2 moles of BOH3, boron trihydroxide. After that, this molecule undergoes acetylation process. Acetylation process means what? Acyl group is replaced by OH group by using acetic anhydride. This is what? Acetic anhydride, or you can also use for acetylation process acetyl chloride instead of acetic anhydride. Okay, so here we have to use acetic anhydride. This acetic anhydride is acylated this OH group, that means simple OH group is replaced by, or this hydrogen is replaced by C double bond O CH3. This is acyl group, and your byproduct is CH3COH. Here, two times acetylation process take place. This hydrogen is replaced by acyl group, and another hydrogen is also replaced by acyl group. Okay, two times acylation process take place, and this 2OH group is completely converted into acyl group. Okay, and your byproduct is 2 moles of acetic acid. Then this last product undergoes pyrolysis, and you will get the new molecule This molecule indicate OH group is completely converted into C double bond C. Okay, that means simple in the last step. Simple, you can say here is also presence of 3 hydrogen. Simple acetic acid it get removed and you will get double bond in the next step after pyrolysis. That means acetic acid is removed in the pyrolysis process. Then after that this molecule undergoes hydrogenation process in the presence of lithium aluminium hydride. What happen when reduction take place? Your OAC group is converted into OH group. So that is simple reduction process. Okay, so how to reduce this OAC bond? This is your OAC bond. Your hydrogen is added across this oxygen and carbon linkage and you will get OH instead of OAC. So that is your grandisol. That is your first synthesis. Okay, then next synthesis is synthesis of bombicol from acetylene. This is also very important and it is for 3 or 4 marks. First synthesis, that is grandisol, it is very important and it is for 4 marks. Okay, it is for also 4 marks. Then we have to see the synthesis of bombicol from acetylene. As we know, the acetylene molecule CH triple bond CH, this one is acetylene molecule. This acetylene molecule is reacts with soda amide, that is NaNH2. Then you will get simple this hydrogen is replaced by sodium and your byproduct is NH3. That means sodium acetylene molecule is formed into next step. Then this sodium acetylene or acetylene sodium is reacts with 1,2,3 propyl bromide. That is what? Propyl bromide. After that you will get this molecule and a removal of NaBr. Br from this carbon and sodium from this carbon, NaBr you get removed and you will get this molecule. What is the name of this molecule? First carbon, second, third, fourth and fifth. Fifth carbon atom, 5 carbon atom in the longest continuous chain, that means it is a pent and first position have a triple bond, so it is pent 1YNE and it is triple bonded molecule. It is called as alkyne. Again this pent 1YNE is reacts with sodium amide or soda amide in the presence of liquid NH3. Then you will get the next molecule, that is sodium pent 1YNE. Here is also removal of NH3 group, NH2 from this sodium and hydrogen from this carbon, and your sodium is replaced by hydrogen molecule. So you will get this intermediate and removal of NH3. Then again this sodium pent 1YNE is reacts with Grignard reagent, and this Grignard reagent is also in the presence of formic acid. What is it? Formic acid, HC double bond O OH. So after reaction of Grignard reagent, formic acid and this sodium pent 1-yne, you will get the intermediate. The name of intermediate is 1 2 3 4 5 6. 6 carbon atom in the longest continuous chain, because one carbon is also getting from this formic acid, or you may say it is methanoic acid. So 6 carbon atom in the longest continuous chain. Second position have a double bond, so we have to write the name hex 2-en, and first position have a OL group. So this is hex 2-en 1-OL, the name of this intermediate. Then again this intermediate is reacts with phosphorus tribromide. After that, the role of phosphorus tribromide is your OH group is replaced by Br. Okay, here we have to see the OH group is replaced by Br after addition of phosphorus tribromide into alcohol. This is reaction of alcohol. Then next one is this intermediate. What is the name of intermediate 1 2 3 4 5 6? 1 bromo hex 2-yne. This is also second position is also have a YN. Okay, so this is your next intermediate molecule. This intermediate is reacts with again phosphorus triphenyl phosphine in the presence of phenyl lithium. Then you will get this triphenyl phosphine is nucleophile. This nucleophile is enters into this intermediate, then you will get phosphorus triphosphyl bromide. You will get then this triphosphyl bromide is undergoes Whiting reaction with this molecule, and you will get such type of intermediate. Okay, then this intermediate undergoes Lindner catalyst, palladium barium sulfate in the presence of hydrogen alkynes cis alkene. Then that means you will get cis alkene molecule is converted into alkynes. Okay, that means again 2 hydrogen is also eliminate from this 2 adjacent carbon and form triple bond here. Again this intermediate is reduction take place in the presence of lithium aluminium hydride, and you will get bombicol. That is what bombicol, and here is also presence of triple bond. This lithium aluminium hydride is convert this acetyl ethyl acetate group is converted into CH2OH. That means you have to also write in the form of this way. Just we have to add across this double bond 2-2 hydrogen, that means CH2 conversion, and here is also instead of OAT, across this OAT bond we have to add hydrogen and hydrogen, that means here totally converts COAT group is into CH2OH. Okay, so this is Bombicol synthesis. And when we have to do the Whiting reaction in the Bombicol synthesis, we have to use the ester form of alkane. Okay, remember this. And your triphenylphosphine Br- molecule, and this aldehyde group is totally removed and formation of double bond take place in this intermediate, and remaining part is same. Okay, so this is all about Bombicol synthesis. Last synthesis is disparture from 6-methyl hept 1 ene. How to go the name of this structure? Numbering start from this carbon 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, total 7 carbon atom, that means it is a hept indicates 7 carbon atom. Then one position have a double bond, so it is 1 ene. And why I am writing here 6 methyl? Because 6 position have a methyl group. This reactant when reacts with hydrogen bromide in the presence of hydrogen peroxide undergoes anti-Markovnikov's rule addition. What is mean by anti-Markovnikov's rule? Unsymmetrical alkene, this is what unsymmetrical alkene, because adjacent carbon have a different number of hydrogen. First carbon atom have a 2 hydrogen, second carbon atom have a 1 hydrogen, and this alkyl group. So it is unsymmetrical alkene. When unsymmetrical alkene is added into unsymmetrical reagent, that is HBr is what? Unsymmetrical reagent, because hydrogen and bromine both are different. Okay, then negative part of the reagent, what is the negative part? Hydrogen is positive, Br is negative. Negative part of the reagent is added or attached to that carbon which have higher number of hydrogen, that means Br goes to first carbon and hydrogen goes to second carbon. Then you will get the Markovnikov's anti-Markovnikov's rule addition, that is what? CH2, this first carbon attached to CH2 group, a CH2 group attached to Br, and here carbon group is attached to hydrogen. Here I am writing condensed formula because I am not indicating the longest continuous chain, so that's why I corrected here. Your structure is like this: CH3, CH, CH3, CH2, 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 Br. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 carbon atom. And where is your anti-Markovnikov's rule addition? Here. Negative part is attached to that carbon which have a higher number of hydrogen. That means first carbon atom have attached to Br group and hydrogen is attached to second carbon, because second carbon atom have a 1 hydrogen only. So that's why. Then in the presence of triphenylphosphine, in the also we have to use phenyl lithium, then you will get this triphenylphosphine, this is nucleophile, this nucleophile is attached with CH2 molecule, and your Br is removed from this solution or remain in its solution. You can also indicate like this, and phosphorus after attacking with CH2, your phosphorus valency will less, so that's why we have to indicate positive charge. Then this intermediate after any addition of triphenylphosphine is reacts with undecanone means what? It is the form of ketone, okay, or you may also say it is form of aldehyde, okay. There are 1, 9, 10, total 10, and this one is also 11. That means it is undecanone in the presence of butyl lithium, okay. Then you will get this longest continuous chain molecule. Here the two molecule is connected by using this carbon-carbon double bond, and a removal of H2 molecule in this step, okay. So remember this step. After that oxidation take place, metachloro per benzoic acid. Where is oxidation take place? At the carbon-carbon double bond, and formation of this oxirane molecule. That means the extra hydrogen in metachloro per benzoic acid is added across this carbon-carbon double bond, and formation of carbon-oxygen-carbon linkage, and this product is in the cis form. This both hydrogen is at the same site, so it is called as cis product, and the name of the product is Disparcher. So this is all about the Disparcher synthesis, okay. So in this lecture we have to see, or we are completed Grandisol. Then second synthesis is Bombicol, and third one is Disparcher, okay. So all of the three synthesis are very important to your exam, okay. Thank you.